about the sign.
All rise, please. Who gives their blessing for this woman to marry this man?
Her mother and I.
Thank you. You may be seated. Let's pray. Father, we come to you this afternoon, and Lord, I just thank you so much for this wonderful opportunity to bless the joining of Kelsey and Jeremy. And Lord, I thank you for the way you brought them together. Thank you for all the things you've done in their relationship up till now, and Lord, I look forward to seeing what you're going to do in the future. So Lord, we offer up this afternoon to you. We offer up this wedding ceremony to you, and Lord, we pray for your presence. We pray that, Lord, just for everything that's said and done here to glorify you. And we pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. We're here this afternoon to celebrate the joining of Kelsey Jones and Jeremy Art in holy matrimony. And this is a very special day for me as well. Because, you know, there's the old expression, always the bridesmaid, never the bride. But this time it's always the usher and never the groom. And now, Jeremy, we get you to move from the back to the front. And I tell you, just it's an honor for me to get to officiate, you know, because Jeremy, you're like a son to us, and we got used to you being at our house at every holiday, and then suddenly you stopped, and that's when I knew this day was coming. But just so, just the way that Kelsey and Jeremy, that God has brought the two of you together, and seeing the way you compliment one another, I don't know of any other woman who would could be such a baseball fan with Jeremy, share his love for the Washington Nationals. I'm not sure about the Dodgers, but just the way that, you know, just seeing you and your interest and everything else, just the way that you, God has truly brought you together. Because one of the things about marriage is that it's like that the two halves truly make a whole. The Bible says that in marriage that you become one flesh. And that means where you fulfill one another. You really do. You don't complete one another. I don't like that phrasing, because it means you were incomplete before, and that's not true. You had very full lives. But as God brings you together, there's that complementing, the filling of gaps in one another. And it just is a very special moment to see. And it's because you love one another that you're here. But, you know, there's more than marriage to marriage than just being in love, because there will be times where, you know, that love is put to the test. And there's strains, and it's just the ups and downs of life. And so I want to talk about what love really is, because when we talk about marriage being based on love, the best verse on this is found in the book of 1 Corinthians. But, you know, before we read that, there's some other things about the foundation of marriage that we'd like to share. And so Jeremy and Kelsey have asked his sisters to share a couple of readings. So Shelby would like for you to come first.
A reading from Romans 12, 9 through 16. Love must be sincere. Hate what is evil. Cling to what is good. Be devoted to one another in love. Honor one another above yourselves. Never be lacking in zeal, but keep your spiritual fervor serving the Lord. Be joyful in hope, patient in affliction, and faithful in prayer. Share with the Lord's people who are in need. Practice hospitality. Bless those who persecute you. Bless and do not curse. Rejoice with those who rejoice. Mourn with those who mourn. Live in harmony with one another.
And now, Jennifer, would you come?
Okay, I'm going to try not to cry. Try. An excerpt from screenwriter Aaron Sorkin's commencement address. I wish you joy. I wish you health and happiness and success. I wish you a roof, four walls, a floor, and someone in your life that you care about more than you care about yourself. Someone who makes you start saying we, where before you used to say I, and us, where you used to say me. I wish you the quality of friends I have and the colleagues I work with. Baseball players say they don't have to look to see if they hit a home run, they can feel it. So I wish for you a moment soon, when you really put the bat on the ball, when you really get a hold of one and drive it into the upper deck, when you feel it, when you aim high and hit your target, when just for a moment, all else disappears and you soar with wings as eagles. The moment will end as quickly as it came, and so you will have to have it back, and so you'll get it back no matter what the obstacles. A lofty prediction, to be sure, but I flat out guarantee it.
I like that, because Jeremy, you've hit a home run. You truly have. I'd like to read 1 Corinthians 13. It builds on what Shelby read on love. Because it says, love is patient and kind. Love is not jealous or boastful or proud or rude. It does not demand its own way. It is not irritable and keeps no record of being wrong. It does not rejoice about injustice, but rejoices whenever the truth wins out. Love never gives up. Love never loses faith. It is always hopeful and endures through every circumstance. And when you think about the fact that You say, all right, we're about to make a commitment to one another, to love one another for the rest of our lives. And this is what this really means. It's not just that you promise to have the feelings of love that you have right now, but to go beyond that. And so when you make a commitment to love, what you're saying, Jeremy and Kelsey, is you're saying, I'm committing to you to be patient with you. And I'm asking you to be patient with me because there will be times that I really need that. I'm asking you to be kind with me on those days when it's not easy. And I'm committing myself to be kind to you when those days are hard in reverse. You're saying, I commit myself to not be jealous, but to always trust you. To never be boastful, proud, or rude, but to always seek out the best for you. Because love always considers the other person to be more important than yourself. And so as you commit to love, you're saying, I'm committing to die to myself so I can do these things for you. You're saying that I'm committing not to be irritable. Now, I know that's hard to do, especially when the Nationals, if they lose or things don't go well, there are those days. But what you're saying is that those days are going to be temporary. And you're saying, I'm going to love you through those days when it's you. It says, I keep no record of being wrong, because there are times when you love somebody that you have disagreements, and there will be arguments, and there will be things that are said. But when you love one another, when you calm down, you come back to one another, and you say, please forgive me as I forgive you. And there is no record of those wrongs being kept. Those things are never brought up again, because they're just lost. And why? How can you do this? It's because I've committed to love you. And the thing about love, it says it does not rejoice with injustice, but rejoices whenever the truth wins out. It never gives up, never loses faith, is always hopeful, and endures through every circumstance. And as you commit to love like that, you're saying, I commit to never give up on you, to never lose faith in you, to always think the best of you, to always be hopeful about our future together. And that the love that I pledge to you today is going to endure through every circumstance. Because there will be better or worse. There's going to be richer or poorer. There's going to be all these things. But you know, really, the thing that's about love, and this is what is so great about what you're entering into, is that from this moment forward, those difficult times are really what's going to make you even closer. And those are going to be the memories, and those are going to be the stories you tell and you talk about. The times you laugh together, the times you cry together. Everything you go through, you're building this adventure together. So in light of what love means, do you, Jeremy, take Kelsey to be your lawful wedded wife? Do you commit to God to love her as Christ loved the church, and to cling to her for better or worse, through sickness and in health, through prosperity and adversity from this day forward, till death do you part?
I do.
Do you, Kelsey, take Jeremy to be your lawful wedded husband? Do you commit to God to love him forever and to cling to him for better or worse, through sickness and in health, through prosperity and adversity from this day forward, till death do you part?
I do.
Awesome. Is there a ring? The rings that are given... I planned on having...
I didn't realize both hands would take it.
The rings that you give to one another, the significance of it is... There's lots of things you can say about the gold and everything, but you know, the thing that stands out the most is that from this day forward, that ring is a testimony. It is a sign of your commitment. Everyone who sees that will know that you have committed your heart to another person, to never give up on them, and to always endure with them. So Jeremy, as you place the ring on Kelsey's finger, would you repeat after me? With this ring.
I thee wed.
And pledge to you.
All my love and devotion.
I vow to you this day.
That I will love you.
And you only.
I will cling to you.
I will cherish you.
For as long as I shall live.
So help me God. Now, Kelsey, would you take this? And as you place it on Jeremy's finger, please repeat after me.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
And pledge to you.
and pledge to you
all my love and devotion.
All my love and devotion.
I vow to you this day.
I vow to you this day
that I will love you.
That I will love you.
And you only.
And you only.
I will cling to you.
I will cling to you.
And cherish you.
And cherish you.
For as long as I shall live.
For as long as I shall live.
So help me God.
So help me God.
As the two of you come together, it's more than just two lives coming together. It is two families, but more than that, it is everything you've experienced up to this point is now coming together as one. And one of the great ways that Kelsey and Jeremy, I get a little nervous too. Sarah asked me, do you ever get nervous? And I said, no, but I do, because I'm going to say the wrong thing. But Kelsey and Jeremy have chosen a way of symbolizing this. Jeremy grew up in the desert in 29 Palms, California. And so his family has brought some sand from the golf course there, one of the sand traps, where he spent so much of his time. And then Kelsey's family has brought sand from the lake where she grew up. And those two now are going to be blended into one.
I pray you'll be our eyes and watch us where we go and help us to be wise in times when we don't know. With your grace to a place where we'll be safe. I pray we'll find your light and hold it in our hearts and stars go out each night. Remind us where you are. Let this be our prayer when shadows fill our day. Lead us to a place. Guide us with your grace. Give us faith so we'll be safe. A world where pain and sorrow will be ended, and every heart that's broken will be mended, and we'll love. Let this be all.
Just like every child needs to find a place, guide us with your grace, give us faith so we'll be safe. Needs to find a place, guide us with your grace, give us faith so we'll be safe.
To read a special wedding blessing. I love the words of this that you've chosen from Max Licato. We ask the Lord, would you take these two of dust and bone, born of flesh, then would you make them one? Would you speak again the words you spoke when Adam slept and Eve awoke? Would you let your wine replace our water and look with grace on this son, this daughter? O Lord of Eden, in your majesty, create again your tapestry, one heart where there were two. This is the prayer we lift to you. Amen and amen. Kelsey, Jeremy, it is my privilege as a minister of the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ to pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss the bride. It is my privilege to get to present for the very first time Mr. and Mrs. Jeremy and Kelsey Art.